Hi, everybody. Welcome to Lori Krein's Art Studio. Today, we're going to be doing a really fun project on mask art. There's a lot of different techniques that you can use for mask art. You can buy a pre-made mask, or you can make one of your own face, and you need some help with that. So today, the first thing we're going to do is do a mask on someone's face. And so before I get started, I just wanted to remind you that if you need to get more information about a mask art or about workshops or anything else about Lori Krein Studios, you can go on to LoriKreinStudios.com, and that's another way that you can contact me as well through the website. And if you decide to do a mask art project, I'd love to hear from you. I'd love to see pictures of what you're doing, and I'll post them on my site for others to see. So with that, I wanted to let you know that today we're going to be filming from my studio in San Jose, California. And we have a couple of other people here with us I wanted to introduce real quick. First, we have Carolina, who is going to be getting the mask done on her face. And we have Electra, who is in the art class with us this week. And we have Evan, who's also in the art class. And we have Gina, who is behind the camera. So, hi, Gina.
Hi.
Thanks for being our video person for today.
Yeah.
So, first, I want to go over with everybody the materials that you need to do a mask, and you can buy these at any local craft store. This is called Rigid Wrap, and it comes in a bag and in a package like this, and it even gives you directions on the back of how to do a mask. And this is what it looks like. It looks like that stuff that you use to make a cast. So the first thing you want to do is cut it into strips about this size, and you need a whole bunch of them, and that's what we're going to be using. You want to have some Vaseline. And the Vaseline is used to put on the person's face beforehand, especially around the hair area, so that the mask doesn't stick to them and it's easy to remove. Then you need a pair of scissors to cut your strips, and you want to have some water available to dip the strips in, warm water if you can. And the person needs to be covered up with a shirt and everything, because it's just going to get very messy and drippy, so you want to protect their clothing from the materials. So I wanted to show you that a mask that's already been done, so you can see kind of what this might look like at the end. This is another mask that I did a while ago, and you can see that the person is still going to need to breathe, so we didn't cover the bottom of the nose in this case so that they could breathe. Another option is you could put a straw in the person's mouth to let them breathe through their mouth. So Carolina has decided that you want to try doing both of those. Are you just say the mouth?
Just the mouth.
Just the mouth. So I'm going to grab a straw. Okay, so Carolina's all set. We've got our straw, we've got our pieces, and I'm going to demonstrate a couple pieces first, and then we're going to have Electra and Evan are going to give it a shot as well. So basically, all you're doing is you're just dipping your piece into the water, and then maybe running it along the side to get the excess water out. And then the first thing you want to do, you want to keep your eyes closed, and you want to head back a little bit. The first two pieces are supposed to be across the first cross, right across the nose. And you just want to press it down so it forms. And if it gets wrinkled, it's okay. The next one. You probably want to make these strips a little bit thinner than I do. They're a little bit too fat. It's hard to get them, especially across the bridge of the nose. Okay, and then you just keep adding them. Going to be water dripping everywhere. You just smooth it out with your finger to kind of get the plaster done. So the plaster is attached.
Thank you.
So we're just going to keep on watching as we cover her face. And then after we're done, we'll show you what it looks like. So keep on. Cover her whole mouth except for the straw. You know, you want to get under her nose, on top of her nose. Yeah, keep going.
We need to do about 4 or 5 layers.
Okay.
Yeah. So keep going. Maybe 3 or 4. Probably.
And yeah, if you need to cut them into smaller pieces.
You can probably do a little bit more on the side from there.
Okay, so we have covered her face with the plaster, and now we're just going to wait about 10 minutes for it to dry, if that. It might be dry even sooner than that. It's already feeling like it's getting kind of hard. So we'll come back in a few minutes and show you what it looks like when we peel it off. Okay, welcome back. So the mask is now dry, and we're going to take it off of her face and see what it looks like. So I hope this works. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, we didn't put enough Vaseline on. We can't get it off. She has to stay like this all day.
So I'm just taking a paintbrush and sticking it in between the mask and her skin in places where it's a little stuck. You don't want to use a hard instrument because it might hurt. The paintbrush is soft and it should, and it is getting it, releasing it from her skin because I didn't put enough Vaseline on. Sorry. You okay?
Yeah.
Does it hurt?
No, it's okay.
There we go!
Woohoo! Awesome.
Okay, so the mask is off, and that's what it looks like on the outside, and that's what it looks like on the inside. So thank you, Carolina, for being the brave soul to get the mask done, and that's how you do a mask. And now we're going to start decorating the mask, so we'll come back in a minute and show you how that process works.
Mask art is something that's traditional in many cultures. African mask art specifically is more well known than others, but there's lots of different purposes for mask art, including spiritual and ritualistic, and just for fun in theater. So today we're going to be doing some masks, and this is an example of one of the masks that I've done, and we're going to show you the technique of how to do these. So it's not the traditional mask that you're going to decorate and then kind of that you would wear on your face. It's not those. These are going to be ones that you can hang up on your wall and admire. So that's an example of one. This is another one, and this only has 2 pieces of paper. It's got the background, the black, and then this one piece that I covered on top of the mask. And this one has 3 pieces. It's got the background, and then a purple, and then another piece of purple covering the top. So this is the technique that you can learn. And the first thing that we're going to do is cover our canvas. And you can use a square canvas, a rectangle, it doesn't really matter. But basically, we're going to just be covering the canvas like you would wrap a present. So you're going to cut the paper the size a little bit larger than the canvas, cut around it, and then glue it on. And you can choose any color. And I've already finished that. Ta-da! So this is what your canvas is going to look like. The next thing I want to share with you is the supplies that you need. You need your acrylic matte medium, which is watered down a little bit. And you want a pair of scissors, a paintbrush, and of course you need a mask. The mask that I use, I purchased at a local craft store. I bought these at Michael's, and they are nice and sturdy so that they won't fall apart when you add the paper to them. So we're going to let the rest of the people in the class get started on theirs, and then we're going to come back in a minute and show you how to apply the mask onto the canvas after it's covered. So one of the first things that you need to decide when you're doing your mask is if you want the eyes of your mask to be open or closed. So this is an example of the eyes being open. And this one, I wouldn't say closed, they're covered. They're covered with the paper. If you're going to have the eyes open, there's two different ways that you can do that. The easiest way is to do the eyes before you start adhering the mask to the canvas. So here I have a piece of paper, and I've already cut a little bit in the middle of it. And I'm just going to lie this paper on top of the mask, right over the eye. And then I'm going to glue it down. So the reason you want to do this before you stick it down onto your canvas is because then you can get to the back of it, just flip it around, and you get to the back, and then you can fold down the little tabs that you've cut. Okay. So if you now turn it around to the front, you've got that eye. I know I'm going to have to patch a couple areas where it's white, but that's, you know, you can take care of that later. So when you're covering the eye, that's how you cover the eye. Put it around the back. If you've already put your mask on your canvas, you can still open the eye up. It's just a little bit harder to do. So that's the first thing. The next thing is then you're going to stick it down onto your canvas.
Okay, we're back. So everyone's covered their canvas with their background paper. So they all look kind of like this. Now the next step, or actually even before you cover the background, you want to remember if you're going to hang this up on the wall, you want to put a hook on the back of your canvas. You can use a single hook or you can use two D hooks. And you put one on this side, you put one on that side, and they sell these at any home improvement store or hardware store or an art supply store. And then you put a wrapped wire, picture hanging wire, in between the two so that you can hang this on the wall. Now, sometimes I have forgotten to put the wire on the back, and in that case, it's pretty hard to hold this down flat. I have to put this down flat on a table. So what you have to do is find a box, and you put it down on top of the box, and that way the face, the mask, goes inside the box, and you can still work on the back of the canvas. So just in case you forget, that's another option for you. Okay, so once you've gotten the back of your canvas covered, the next step is to attach your mask and decorate the mask at the same time. So it looks, on the outside, it appears that this mask is coming through the canvas. But it really is not. As you can see, the back of the canvas is still solid. So
So the mask is actually glued onto the front. Now, we don't glue the mask onto the front of the canvas separately. We use the paper to attach it. So I'm going to show you how that works. And all I'm going to do today for my decoration, I'm not going to think too much about this. I just took out my red scrap box, and I'm just going to create strips of red paper. And the way that I did that is I took my water, a pointy brush, and I just drew lines on my paper with the water. And then wherever the lines are, that's where the paper will tear. So then I'm just going to tear the paper up into strips. Now, there's many ways that you can attach or decorate your mask. Doing strips is just one of them. This paper is just one single piece of paper that I glued onto the back, and then I smooshed it onto the face. And we're going to show that demonstration in another show. For today's show, we're just going to use strips. So I take my scrap box here, and I'm just going to pull out a variety of colors of red, shades of red, that I've been collecting left over from other projects, because we never throw anything away. We want to reuse as much as possible. And today we're using, this is Lokta paper. So I've got a few strips. I just take my glue, and I put glue down on my paper. And so I'm putting glue down on my paper, and it'll probably soak in. And you lift it up, and you take it over to your mask, and you just put glue back down on the top. And you let it go off to the side a little bit. And when you keep doing that across the whole mask, you see that it will attach, that's what attaches the mask to the canvas, is those little things on the side. So now I'm going to put on another piece. You might hear some noises in the background. We are in a working studio space, and there are people doing all kinds of projects here today. So you hear some funny noises going on, that's why. So here I'm going to add another strip of red. And if your mask starts to move around a little bit while you're doing the early pieces, you just have to keep moving it back. And you want to do a few pieces on either side. So I have a couple pieces there, and now I'm going to put a couple pieces across the other side to make it stay down and to make it easier to work with. So now I'm putting a strip on this side. And we're going to be putting lots of layers on this mask with the strips. So I'm not paying too much attention to exactly where they're going right now, because it's going to be covered up. Part of it's going to be covered up anyway. So we're going to keep working with this, and we'll come back in a few minutes after I have a few more done, and then we'll talk some more. Thank you. so I'm back, and as you just saw, you watched the evolution of this mask. We have some visitors out in the hallway, as you can hear. I created this mask by just taking scraps of red paper, making strips out of them, and adhering them onto the mask. So I've got the base done, and I could just leave it at that. It looks pretty good. But I'm going to add a few more things to it just to give it a little bit more interesting aspects. So I'm going to hold it like that. Does that work? So this, what I'm going to add on here is this sort of netting, red netting stuff, and I'm going to be peeling off some of the threads so I can leave kind of a fringe. So I think that looks pretty cool. So I'm going to peel off a bunch of the pieces. I know I have to cut off the end there, and then I can pull off some of the edge pieces. So it kind of looks like that, and I can pull some out of the middle as well. Put more space between there. Sometimes they're hard to pull out. Okay, that's good. So anyway, I just glue this down just like I would the paper. And I'm going to put this right above the eyes to kind of give it a little bit of a mysterious look. And this kind of material requires a little bit of extra glue. So I'm going to lay the glue on pretty thick, and then I'll remove the extra afterwards. So I'm still using the acrylic matte medium. Okay, so I have added this piece of netting to the mask, and I'm just getting out the extra glue. And I kind of like the way it overhangs on the eyes. So you can add all kinds of things to your mask at this point if you want to. I also have some string, just some regular, it's actually embroidery thread that I split up. So when your embroidery thread comes kind of thick and it's like five pieces of thread together, and I usually separate out the individual strands of thread because I think that using it as it is with the embroidery thread is just too thick. So I just pull it apart and use the individual pieces like that. So I'm probably just going to add a little bit of string to the outside of the mask because I think it needs something around the edge, but not too much. So I'm just kind of randomly placing the string with the glue, and I'm using my matte medium again to put the string on. And I'll just keep doing that around the whole edge until my mask is done. So that's basically how you do a mask when you're doing the strips of paper across. You can cut them or tear them, it's kind of up to you. And it's kind of fun to just try using shades of the same color on the mask just to see what that looks like. It kind of looks interesting. But, you know, do whatever you kind of you are into doing. So the next time we're going to try a mask with one piece of paper and see how that goes. For now, let's check back in with the students in the class today, and we'll see how they're going along with their masks. And we'll show some pictures of some of the other mask art that I've done to conclude. And I want to thank you for joining me today. And remember, you can visit my website, LoriKreinStudios.com, to get any more information, send us photos of your work, or to send me an email. Thanks. Have a good day. Bye-bye. Okay, hi, we're back. So Gina is, this is Gina's mask that she created during class, and it's very cool. We just talked about composition and how her mask, the eye, is sort of a spiral, so it draws the viewer in to look at the eye, and then the mouth has all these X's on it. And then we have this piece of paper over on the side. So we're looking over here, and then we look over here. So our eye is moving all the way around the canvas. So now Gina wants to just say a few words about her piece. And take it away, Gina.
Well, basically, I want to do kind of a scary thing, I guess, and also add color. So then, you know, kind of go with the black and I think red goes well with black, so it's red, and I thought making a stitch mouth would be cool, so I did that, and also like shiny silver, so that's how I got the eye. which came out of this paper, and it was also good. And just the purple too, so it wouldn't be too boring. That's about it.
All right. Thanks, Gina. Good job. Good job, everybody. And now we're going to show some pictures of what everybody did for their mask art, and we'll be signing off. Have a good day. Thanks. See you next time.